Let's talk now about project templates. Now there are two types of templates within eSolve. There's actually the project template and there's an occurrence template. What is a template? Well, this is an important concept for you to understand. As the administrator of eSolve, you have the ability to set up the application so that certain security protocols are in place. Well, each time you build a project, you have to go into the security settings and identify those particular permissions project per project. That's the starting point because, as you remember from the user training, all security is inherited from that particular project. Now, we are going to be discussing the actual security protocols a little bit later, but it's important for you to understand that the concept of a template does two things. First of all, it sets some standards or parameters around creating a particular project so you can reuse that type or classification project again and again. Secondly, it allows you to establish some consistent security protocols. And third, it allows you to pre-assign various tasks prior to the beginning of a project. Go to the main drop-down menu system, select System Administration, and move your mouse down the navigation tree until you see Project Templates. Go ahead and click on Project Templates. On the right side, a list of sample project templates appear. Now, these templates represent sample database information that has been designed for you as a sample only. If you click on a particular template, you will see that a form opens up. At the top right, Project Templates is identified, and you can see what resembles the first top right side of a project data entry form. Now, there's much more than just simply predefining the scope, the title, and the category of a particular project. It also allows for you to put in some pre-designed function permissions. Let's take a look at the project template form. At the very top, the first thing that you can do is identify an agency. So if we're going to select a particular template, it's predetermined that an agency is responsible for this particular project. Now remember, we talked about agencies previously, and agencies are partners of the users within eSolve. In other words, they're participants in the projects and the investigations. You can give a title for a particular project template. So if you're continually investigating a particular type of incident, then you can provide a consistent title that would appear for every one of those classifications of incidents or projects. The scope can provide some consistent clarification of what this project is about. And then, of course, over on the right side, you can predetermine whether it is an investigation, an intelligence probe, a research project, or whatever it is that you need to do within eSolve. You can even pre-establish a supervisor. You can pre-establish who it's assigned by and assigned to. But most importantly is you can set some security protocols down in that bottom function permissions area. Now, we're going to be talking about security a little bit later, so I'm going to leave this area until we get in and drill down into the security permissions of the eSolve application. But at the very bottom of this particular template, notice that you see something called template assignments. If you click on one of those assignments in the list, it will take you to an assignment data entry form. However, this assignment data entry form is slightly different in that it looks like the top portion, that's the top right portion of an assignment form, but notice it's missing the navigation tree on the left, and it's missing those bar graphs and pie chart graphs and metric information in the bottom right. That's because you're not actually entering in a new assignment, you're creating a template that can be used in the future when you initiate this particular project. This is a very powerful tool. Imagine that you want to create a project. Maybe there are projects that you deal with on a regular basis. And knowing that for the first 10, 20, or 50 times, there are assignments that are consistently needed to be completed for each one of these projects. Well, you can pre-record those assignments, even pre-assign those assignments to a particular investigator or user in advance of that project actually occurring. This is a very powerful tool because it allows you to start that project right out of the gate with several workflow initiatives already started. Let's create a brand new project template. From the list of project templates, go up to the top right where it says New, click on New, and a blank project template form appears. Notice you can select an agency. Go ahead and pick from the list of sample agencies within the sample database. Put in the title something like Research Project ESOL Major Case Management. And the scope might be anything in relation to that particular project. The category, I'll leave that up to your imagination, can be something like an occurrence or something like a research area. And then the subcategory falls from that, whether it would be an environmental or legal or some other issue. The status, again, can be monitoring, compiling, consulting, whatever the choices are in that particular drop-down menu. And you can identify a supervisor, assigned by, or assigned to. Now, the other thing that I want you to do is, for now, change a couple of the settings down in the function permissions. For example, in the area of security, change that to 50. In read, change that to 20. In write, change that to 20. In create, change that to 20. In conclude, change that to 30. In delete, change that to 90. And in system, change that to 90. In essence, what you've done there is you've created several of the security permissions in advance of that project being created. Go ahead and click on apply once you've completed all the mandatory field areas and you've created a new project template. From this point now, you have a blank area in the bottom that allows you to create some template assignments. Go ahead and click on new in the middle portion of your template form right above that list. When you click on new, you're presented with a blank assignment template form. Repeat this process several times and create some advanced assignments in relation to your particular project. Try this by creating a couple other project templates, several other assignments, and start to practice and work through the various procedures for creating a template in relation to a project.